Hello, I'm Alan Thorn, and I would like to warmly welcome you to this video tutorial in which I will guide you, step by step, through the process of exporting a 3D mesh and its material from a modelling application, in this case Maya, into the Unity engine where it can be added to our scenes and levels. We will look at preparing our model for export, the export process itself, and then how to configure the model optimally in Unity. So with that said, let's get started. So here we are in Maya, looking at this rather uninspiring looking cube mesh. Now of course, you are not restricted to exporting only cube meshes and simple primitives. You can export more or less any polygonal mesh that you choose. But I have chosen a cube mesh here for very specific reasons that will become clear later in this video. Now, the first issue that I want to discuss regarding exporting pertains to systems and units. In particular, I want to ensure that the coordinate system in Maya and the coordinate system in Unity have a one-to-one correspondence, so that whatever I model in Maya will be imported into Unity at a consistent size and scale. Now, the units in Unity are called Unity units, and the physics system treats one Unity unit as 1 meter. For this reason, in Maya, I want to ensure that my working units are set up to correspond to this. Now, to set up my working units, I click on Window from the File menu, I choose Settings and Preferences, and then I click Preferences. In the Preferences dialog that appears, I want to choose Settings from the Category box, and in the Working Units section, here in linear units, I can see the unit that I am using. The default is centimeter. And in most cases, in 9 out of 10 cases, I want to leave it as centimeter, not meter. This is because when my file is saved and imported into Unity, centimeters are converted directly into meters, meaning 1 centimeter will turn out to be 1 meter. On a minority of systems and versions of Maya, I will want to select meter because sometimes this conversion does not occur. But on most systems, centimeter works absolutely fine, and so I'm good to go. The next thing that I want to consider regarding exporting is the pivot point of an object. Now, to display the pivot point of any object in Maya, I can select the object, hit the W key on the keyboard, and the pivot point is represented by the gizmo here. You'll see that it's at the center of this cube. The pivot point represents the center of rotation for an object and also the origin of its local coordinate space. And the pivot point is absolutely essential to how objects are positioned in levels in Unity. In particular, if I set the position of this cube to absolutely anywhere, you'll notice that what actually happens is the position of the pivot point is set and the cube simply follows the pivot point. Now, for most game needs, the pivot point should be positioned at the very bottom of a mesh. If it's a character mesh, it will be positioned at the feet. If a vehicle mesh, at the bottom of its wheels. Typically, it is positioned at the bottom so that when the object is positioned in the level, it can align nicely to the floor plane, to the ground plane, or the terrain mesh. To change the position of the pivot point, I can press the Insert key on the keyboard and hold down the X key to snap to the grid, and then I can pull the pivot point downwards to the grid here, and then release. And you'll notice now that the pivot point is set to the bottom of the object and is aligned with the grid. I'm going to press the Insert key again to exit the pivot point mode, and now you'll notice that the transform gizmo appears at the bottom of the cube. One last thing to notice about the pivot point is this blue arrow pointing outwards here. This blue arrow represents the Z axis, and Unity interprets this as the forward vector for the object. If I'm creating a character or a vehicle, I will want to ensure that that mesh is looking in the same direction as that blue forward pointing arrow. Next up, I want to consider the issues of topology and triangulation. Let's start by considering topology. Now, Unity is intended to import only polygonal models, That is only models composed from polygons, those composed from vertices, edges and faces, such as this cube here. If I intend to import NURB surfaces or subdivision surfaces, then I must use Maya to first convert those models into polygonal models. I can do that using the conversion tools Maya provides from the Modify menu here by selecting Modify, Convert, NURBS to Polygons, or Subdiv to Polygons here. I can use either of these two. I don't need to perform any conversion in this case because my cube is already a polygonal mesh. Now, the next thing I want to consider is triangulation. I can bring up the polygon count for any particular object here that we can see the polygon count here. I can show this by selecting display, heads up display and poly count. Now this model happens to be composed from quads, and it is important to mention that Unity will automatically triangulate our model on import. It will convert this model into triangles, so each and every one of these quads will be converted into two triangles. Now, Unity will not perform any further optimizations than that. It will not simplify our mesh in any way. So it is up to us to ensure that our meshes are as simple as they need to be prior to import. You can see with all these divisions here, across the width, a depth and a height, that I have far too many divisions. So if I open the channel box and I open the polycube node here, I can reduce the number of subdivisions to 1, and already here in the viewport you can see my mesh is greatly simplified. Our mesh now is almost ready for export. There are just one or two cleanup operations that I want to perform on the mesh. In particular, I want to delete its modification history and I want to delete its transformations, to ensure that the mesh that is imported into Unity is a cleaned up, consolidated and final raw mesh. Now, to do that, I want to select my mesh here in the viewport, choose Modify, Freeze Transformations, and then Edit and Delete All by Type and History. This will clean up all the edit history on the object and allow us to import only the raw object. The final thing that I want to do is, here in the channel box, you can see the name of the cube is PCube1, which isn't very descriptive. Instead, I'm going to name this Unit Cube, since it has a width, height and depth of 1. Now the cube is ready to export. To do this, I'm going to click File, Save Scene As. I'm going to type in the name here in the file name field, Unit Cube. As for file type, I can select Maya ASCII or binary. It doesn't matter which one you choose. I'm going to go with Maya ASCII and then choose Save. Having done this, the scene is now saved and ready to be imported into Unity. Now we're going to jump over to Unity and import our mesh. So here we are in Unity with a blank project open, ready to import our Maya mesh. To do that, I'm going to open up Windows Explorer. And straight away you can see my mesh file here. I'm going to import that into Unity by dragging and dropping the Maya file into the Unity project panel here and releasing. Straight away, Unit Cube is imported. The name of my mesh is taken from the name of the Maya file. Now, Unity does not automatically import textures with meshes. I have to do that manually. To do that, I'm going to drag and drop my texture into the Unity project panel as well, and then minimize Windows Explorer, and we can see that in the project panel we have both our assets. I'm going to select the Unit Cube mesh, and you'll notice here in the preview pane that we can preview our newly imported mesh. You will see it has a blank material. If I scroll down in the material properties, the mesh properties, I will come across this section which displays the properties for the material associated with the mesh. You will notice that in this texture swatch, it says none. It cannot find our newly imported material. To locate this, I'm going to click the select button and select the newly imported texture from the asset panel here. And straight away in the preview pane, you can see our mesh now has a material applied with the correct texture. I can add my mesh to the scene by dragging and dropping the cube mesh any number of times into the scene. Now, you may remember at the beginning of this tutorial, I mentioned that I had a specific reason for importing a cube mesh. And the reason is because this cube mesh is a unit cube, meaning that in Maya, I sized this cube specifically so that it was one unit in width, height, and depth. We can have Unity generate a unit cube for us, and we can use the Unity unit cube to compare with our Maya unit cube to ensure that the two coordinate systems match. We know that the coordinate systems will match if the two unit cubes are equal in size. To generate a Unity unit cube, click Game Object, Create Other, and Cube. And straight away we can see that we have a newly generated Unity unit cube and that it matches the size of our newly imported Maya cube. This tells us that the coordinate systems of Maya and Unity correspond. So this video has shown you how to import a Maya object into Unity. I hope you have found it helpful. Thank you for watching.